Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Internal Combustion Engine. And this is lecture number 8. The topic is ignition system used in the SI engine. So, the ignition system is responsible for producing spark in the petrol engine and to initiate the ignition of the fuel. And we recap from the previous lecture. So, in the earlier lecture, we studied about the fuel and the fuel supply system in the SI engine. So, in the fuel supply system in the SI engine, we have the main component called carburetor, which is producing air fuel mixer. And this air fuel mixer is supplied to the petrol engine at the end of, during the suction stroke. And the air fuel mixer is compressed during the compression stroke, and at the end of the compression stroke, a small electrical spark is produced using the spark plug, which initiates the combustion of the fuel. So, the spark produced using the spark plug, it is important for combustion of the fuel, and the electric energy for producing the spark is given by the ignition system in the SI engine or petrol engine. So, here we are going to discuss the ignition system. The two types of ignition system, battery ignition system, magneto ignition system, and we compare the battery ignition system and the magneto ignition system in the following slides. So, learning outcome to the student. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the battery ignition system, and the student will be able to discuss the construction and working of the magneto ignition system, and they will be able to compare the battery and the magneto ignition system with respect to their relative advantage and disadvantages. And the ignition system is provided with the SI engine. So, it is only for SI engine. So, the petrol engine, which is used to produce an electric spark at the end of the compressor stroke to ignite the air fuel mixer. Ignite means initiating combustion. So, starting the combustion process. That is what ignition. In the design of an ignition system, the following factors should be taken into account. When you design a ignition system for the engine, you have to consider the engine speed, engine design, intake manifold pressure, and the mixer composition. So, engine design. So, what is the position of the spark plug, and what is the overall dimension of the engine, overall dimension of the combustion chamber, diameter of the chamber, length of the stroke length, everything we have to consider. And the engine speed, whether it is high speed engine or low speed engine, and the pressure in the intake manifold, and the pressure at the end of the compression process, and the mixer composition. So, what is the air fuel ratio in the engine operating condition. These are all the input parameter required for designing a ignition system. And there are two types of ignition system, battery ignition system and the magneto ignition system. We will discuss one by one. So, before we start the types of ignition system, what are the requirement of an ignition system? A smooth and reliable functioning of an ignition system is essential for reliable working of an engine. So, the performance of the engine, power output, efficiency, everything depends on the combustion of the fuel, and the combustion depends on the ignition system. So, it is very crucial design, crucial part of the petrol engine. So, the requirement of such a ignition system, it should provide a good spark between the electrode of the plugs at the correct timing. So, the time of producing the spark, normally before the top dead center, at what crank angle? So, 20 degree, 25 degree, 15 degree. So, depending on the design and the speed of the engine, we have to fix the timing, and the spark should be produced on correct timing. It should function efficiently over the entire range of the engine speed. So, when the engine speed is increasing, we require the electric spark quickly because of a higher speed. When the engine speed reduces, the time gap between the subsequent spark will be more. So, at the range of engine speed, the intensity of the spark that is the current, the voltage, the intensity of the spark should be the same. The intensity should not change. So that is what efficient sparking. So it should be, it should work effectively, efficiently over the entire range of the engine speed. It should be light, effective and reliable service. So it should be light in weight, effective service and reliable service it has to provide. It should be compact and easy to maintain. The ignition system should be compact and easy to maintain. And it should be cheap and convenient to handle. The interference of high voltage. So in the ignition system, high voltage is generated for the sparking. So the high voltage should not interfere the functions of the radio and television receiver inside the automobile. Inside the car, nowadays we have the audio system, video system, and even we are using mobile phone during the travel. And the intensity of the spark, high voltage spark, or the source should not affect the functioning of all the electronic item in the automobile. So the battery ignition system. So these are all the components of the battery ignition system. We require a battery, ignition switch, ballast resistor, ignition coil, contact breaker, capacitor, and a spark plug. So these are all the components of the battery ignition system. And the first we take the battery. And these are all the components. We will explain one by one. So actually this is the storage battery. This is the ignition switch. This is the ignition coil. And we have a distributor, spark plug, and we have the contact breaker here, and this is the capacitor. So the capacitor, contact breaker, distributor, spark plug, ignition coil, ignition switch, and this is the resistor, and we have the battery. So we will explain one by one. First the battery. This is the source of energy. So battery is the source of energy. This provides the energy for ignition. The battery used may be lead acid battery or alkaline battery. Any type of battery we can use. The battery is charged by the dynamo provided in the engine. So engine, actually in the automobile we have a dynamo. The dynamo will charge the battery. Otherwise when you use the current from the battery getting discharged. So when the engine is operating, the battery is charged. The battery must be mechanically strong to withstand the strain to which it is constantly subjected. So it should be in a strong body. The entire battery should be in a strong body. It converts the chemical energy into electrical energy due to the electrochemical reaction taking place inside the battery. So we studied at lower level about the battery, and the battery we are using regularly. So it converts the chemical energy into electrical energy by means of electrochemical reaction inside the battery. And these are all the components we told earlier. Storage battery, ignition switch, ignition coil, and you have the contact breaker, capacitor, ignition distributor, and the spark plug. The second component is ignition switch. So the battery is connected to the primary winding of the ignition coil through an ignition switch and the ballast resistor. So the purpose, with the help of the ignition switch and in the ignition system, can be turned on or off. So this is the switch, purpose of the switch. It is in the dashboard. So with the help of the switch, we can either on or off the entire ignition system. And the ballast resistor. So it is the ballast resistor is provided in series with the primary winding to regulate the primary current. So the objective of this is to prevent injury to the spark coil by overheating if the engine should be operated for a long time at low speed. So when the engine is operating for a long time at low speed, there is a possibility of injury of this ignition coil. So that is prevented by the resistor. So the coil is made by the iron wire. So ballast resistor wire, the material used for the resistor is the iron wire. And the ignition coil. So this is very important component. We have the ignition coil, we have the primary winding and the secondary winding and the magnetic core. So the ignition coil consists of a magnetic core of soft iron sheets and two insulated conduction coil called the primary and the secondary winding. So we have a magnetic core, primary winding, secondary winding. So the secondary winding, secondary coil consists of 21,000 turns of 38 to 40 kg, that is thin wire. So 38 to 40 gauge enameled copper wire sufficiently insulated to withstand the high voltage. So in the secondary coil, the high voltage is produced. So we require more number of winding with thin wire on the core. So it is wound on the core. So it is wound close to the core
with one end connected to the secondary terminal and the other end grounded to the metal case. So in the secondary coil, one end is connected to the output wire and another end is grounded to the metal case. The primary winding located outside the secondary coil generally formed 200 to 300 turns of 20 kg copper wire. So this is thick wire. So the secondary winding more number of turns with a thin wire and the primary winding less number of turns with a thick wire. Because of the thickness of the primary wire, more heat is generated in the primary than the secondary coil. With the primary coil wound over the secondary coil, it is easy to dissipate the heat energy. That is the purpose. So we locate the primary winding outside the secondary winding because more heat is generated in the primary winding, and using the position of the primary winding, we can easily dissipate the heat energy. The entire unit is enclosed in the metal container and form a neat and compact unit. And the contact breaker, so this is a mechanical device for making and breaking the primary circuit of the ignition coil. The metal used for the contact surface usually tungsten, and the diameter of the contact surface is about 3 mm. So contact breaker, whenever you want the spark in the spark plug, you have to open the contact breaker. So it will be done by a automatic cam mechanism. Capacitor, so the principle of construction of a ignition capacitor is same as the electrical capacitor. So the capacitor will supply the current, store the excess current, supply the current back to the primary winding. Two strips of aluminium foil and several layers of special capacitor paper are rolled up in a solid roll. So then the roll is inserted into a metal shell for protection against the moisture and the damage. So capacitor as in the electrical capacitor. And distributor, so this distributes the current. So the function of the distributor is to distribute the ignition current to the individual spark plug in correct sequence and at correct instant of time. So the two types of distributor are brush type and gap type of distributor we are using. And spark plug, the final component is the spark plug. The spark plug provided with the two electrode with a proper gap across which the high potential discharge to generate a spark and ignite the combustible mixture within the combustion chamber. So the spark plug has got two electrode, and the between the gap between the two electrode, the current is producing a spark which will ignite the combustion air fuel mixture in the combustion chamber. The spark plug consists of a steel shell, an insulator and two electrodes. So look at the spark plug here. This is the spark plug, and here in the spark plug we have the central electrode. So terminal shed actually insulator, and this is what the special conductive steel metal, and you have the central electrode, and the central electrode is covered with the insulating material. So the insulating material is ceramic material, porcelain or any ceramic material. And the central electrode is actually here from the ignition system, the current is given to the central electrode. And here we have the metal body, screw portion, and this screw portion is inserted into the cylinder head. And you have a ground electrode, so this is attached to the metal body of the spark plug. And between these two electrodes, there is a small gap, air gap. And in this gap, when the current, high voltage current is coming, flowing in the in the central electrode, between the gap, a high intensity spark is produced to initiate the combustion of the fuel. So this is the construction of the spark plug. So the spark plug provided with the two electrode with a proper gap across which the high potential discharge to generate a spark and ignite the combustible mixture within the combustion chamber. The spark plug consists of a steel shell, an insulator and two electrode. The central electrode to which high tension supply from the ignition coil is connected is well insulated with porcelain or any other ceramic material. The other electrode is welded in the steel shell of the plug. The electrodes are usually made of high nickel alloy to withstand the severe erosion and corrosion to which they are subjected in the use. So the electrodes are exposed to the hot gases and high temperature hot gases, so which will cause corrosion and erosion. So the electrodes are made by nickel alloy. The spark plugs are usually classified as hot plug and the cold plugs depending upon relative operating temperature range of the tip of the high tension electrode. So high temperature, when the temperature is high, they are called a high temperature hot plugs. When the temperature is low, they are called as cold plugs. And this is what the hot plug and the cold plug. You can find out the relative height. So the cold plug, the temperature height is more. In the case of hot plug, the temperature is less. And this is what the construction of operating. So actually, this diagram, it gives the layout of the battery ignition system. And to understand the working of the battery ignition system, you listen to this diagram. For the examination, you have to draw this diagram. So this diagram is enough for explaining the working and construction of the battery ignition system. And look at here. So this is the ballast resistor. This is your ignition switch. This is the ignition coil where we have the primary winding and the secondary winding. This is the cam which is actuating the contact breaker. And here we have the capacitor and the battery. And this is our distributor, and we have four spark plugs. So this is a four cylinder engine. So when the ignition switch is closed, so the current is flowing through the ballast resistor to the primary winding. So the current is flowing through the primary winding. And it is getting the magnetic core and the secondary coil. So this is magnetic core is charged. When you want a spark here, so the ignition switch, actually the contact breaker is open. So by the cam, contact breaker is open. When the contact breaker is open, there is a disturbance in the current flow. So the current from the battery, from the primary winding, it goes to the capacitor. So continuously going to the capacitor, so the primary current decreases. The decrease in the primary winding, for the decrease in the primary winding, from the capacitor, the current will be flowing to the primary winding. So there will be reversal of the current. So the reversal of the current will collapse the magnetic field, and it will induce a high voltage current on the secondary coil. Then the high voltage current will go to the distributor, and the distributor will distribute the spark. For example, here we have the fourth contact with the fourth plug, and the this is spark here. Depending on the contact, so the spark will be produced in a particular spark plug. So here the operation, so I repeat again, so when the switch is closed, the current is flowing through the battery through the ballast resistor to the primary winding. So in the primary winding, the current is flowing from the battery, and when the contact breaker is open, the opening actually it is by the cam. So when the cam, we require a spark, so we open the contact breaker. When the contact breaker is open, so the immediately what will happen, the primary current will flow to the capacitor. When the primary current is continuously flowing to the capacitor, so here the current is, primary current is decreasing, and when it is decreasing, from the capacitor the current is flowing back to the primary winding. So there is a reversal of the current flow. So this reversal of the current flow will collapse the magnetic field, and it will induce a secondary high voltage secondary coil, secondary current, and this secondary high voltage current will go to the distributor, and from the distributor it is distributed to a particular spark plug depending on the timing. So this is the working of a battery ignition system. So in the examination, you draw this circuit and you name the component: battery, ignition switch, ballast this resistor, ignition coil, the capacitor, contact breaker, distributor, and you explain the components and you explain the working of the battery ignition system. And magneto ignition system, the only difference is source of energy. So in the earlier case, in the battery ignition system, battery provided the electrical current. In the magneto ignition system, the magneto is producing on its own current for the primary winding. And the magneto when rotated, so look at here, so we have a core and we have a rotating magnet. So over the core, we have the primary winding and the secondary winding, and we have a rotating magnet, so two poles are shown. And here we have the cam, and here you have the contact breaker and the condenser. Now, the magneto when rotated by the engine is capable of producing a very high voltage and does not need a battery as a source of external energy. So that is the difference. Magneto may be rotating armature type or rotating magnet type. So here we have rotating magnet type. So when the magnet is rotating, so the current is generated, that is called as primary current. And the primary current will flow through the primary coil, and when the contact breaker opens, right? So there will be collapse in the magnetic core, and it will induce the secondary current, and the secondary current will go to the distributor, and the distributor will distribute the current to the high voltage current to a particular spark plug where the spark is produced. So the difference in working and construction is only the battery is replaced by the magneto. So the magneto, it contains a rotating magnet and a armature. So this is what the the difference, and the working and the producing the spark, it is the same. And now we compare the battery ignition system and the magneto ignition system. So battery ignition system, I read vertically, battery is necessary, difficult to start the engine when the battery is discharged. So normally this may occur. So battery, when the engine is not operated for a longer time, the battery is discharged, so it is very difficult to start the engine. Maintenance problem are more due to the battery, and we have to properly maintain the battery. Current for the primary circuit is obtained from the battery. Okay, a good spark is available at the spark plug when even at low speed. So because of the electric energy source is battery, so the battery will supply constant current, so the intensity of the spark even at low speed will be better. Efficiency of the system decreases with the reduction in the spark intensity as the engine speed rises. Occupies more space, commonly employed in the car and light commercial vehicle. And if you take the magneto ignition system, so here battery is necessary. It is difficult to start the engine without the battery. So here battery is not needed. So therefore, there is no problem of battery discharge. So battery is not available here. So that is not a problem. Battery discharge problem is not there. So here because we have the battery, the maintenance problem is there. Here there is no maintenance problem. So then since there is no battery, the current for the primary circuit is obtained from the battery, and this is like electric current generated by the magneto. So the magneto system, it is generating its own current for the ignition system. A good spark is available even at the low speed of the engine, but here the during the starting, the quality of the spark is poor due to the speed, because magneto is rotating when the engine is rotating. So at the start of the engine speed is very low, so the quality of the spark is low in the case of magneto ignition system. The efficiency of the system improves as the engine speed rises due to high intensity spark. So when the engine speed is higher, the efficiency of the magneto ignition system will be better, and it occupies lesser space because there is no battery, so it is occupying lesser space. It is mainly used in the racing car and the two wheeler like mopeds. So in the all mopeds we are using the magneto ignition system. So battery ignition system, it is used in the light duty vehicle cars and light commercial vehicles, and magneto ignition system is used in the racing cars and the two wheelers. So these are all the comparison between the battery and the magneto ignition system. And based on the lecture, so we answer two questions here. First question, to develop high voltage for the spark plug of the spark ignition engine, distributor is installed, ignition coil is installed, carburetor is installed, battery is installed. To develop high voltage for spark plug, which is the component providing the high voltage current to the spark plug. The correct answer is ignition coil. So battery is supplying only 12 volt current, but the 12 volt current is converted into 20 volt by means of ignition coil. So we require high voltage electric current for the spark. So that is produced by the ignition coil. For obtaining required firing order in a spark ignition engine, so we have distributor is installed, ignition coil is installed, carburetor is installed, and battery is installed. So required firing order, in what way we have to give the current to the spark plug. So the distributor is responsible for the distributing the current to a particular spark plug. So distributor is installed. So we stop here. So these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can use it. And we have other books on internal combustion engine. That also you can refer for additional information. So thank you for watching. So please post your comments after seeing the video. Whatever may be your comment, you just post it. So for improvement, and subscribe the YouTube channel so that you will get more updated videos on thermal engineering subject like engineering, thermodynamics, heat and mass transfer, and the solution for the gate question paper also I uploaded for your better learning and to make a pass in the gate examination. So if you have any queries, you can contact me through mail ID or using the WhatsApp number. I will sincerely answer to your queries. Thank you very much, and we will meet again.